So disappointing, obviously, with the loss. And I'll open up for any questions.
Ben was the first one.
Will, on that late third and nine, was kind of the direction that the ball was supposed to go on that screen and just got blown up, or would you have liked to see Colin hand the ball off there?
Offensively, yeah, we should have gotten the ball, gotten rid of the football. Yeah.
David?
Well, just before half, Corral threw an incomplete pass. It looked like his knee was down. Did you guys have a chance to review that? Can you review that play?
Yeah, well, I did not. I think in another situation where the whistle blows and the play's over and the whistle had blown in that situation, and once the whistle blows in the situation, it's not reviewable. No different than the situation in Florida, I guess it was 2 or 3 years ago with JC. I mean, when the whistle blows, the play's over. We had one on our sideline that was for us in a fumble situation. The whistle had blown, and it may or may not have been a fumble with one of our ball carriers. I don't remember who it was. But once the whistle blows, yeah, there's not a reviewable situation.
Bill McGrady.
Why was Coach Bobo down on the sideline as opposed to being in the box, which I'm pretty sure he's been the first few games?
Yeah, Mike just felt like it'd be important with the quarterback situation. It's not being as productive as we need to be to be down on the sideline. And, you know, felt like it was pretty effective. Colin Taylor.
Yeah, well, just how concerning is tonight's defensive performance for you guys, and how do you go about correcting that moving forward?
Well, they're a really good offensive football team, and they've done this to a lot of people. So it is concerning. There's no doubt about that. We've got to go back and look at it. You know, we came in wanting to mix some things up. We played some zone, and he was very accurate. I don't know exactly what he was. Very accurate for the night, 28 of 32. And in man-to-man, we got beat some in man coverage. So it's tough when you can't win man, and then you play zone coverage, and he's very accurate with the football. So we got to, you know, tighten up some zones as far as those things are concerned. They had some really good skill players we had a hard time matching up with in man coverage, and we got beaten some man situations. So, you know, those things are tough when you're when he's that accurate in zone, and then you're struggling in man. We did, you know, I know they got some yards there late running the football, but I thought we did much better in the second half on the run game than we did in the first half. There's no question. They got a very good skill football team. They do a good job of spreading the field and making you defend it all. And, you know, they did a good job. They got a good offensive team. Josh Kendall.
Will, Kevin Harris's performance tonight, did you think that was possible when you looked at their – you might think that was possible against this defense?
Yeah, we felt good coming in the game being able to run the football. We wanted to shorten the game as best we could. You know, we felt like, you know, if we could limit in their snaps somewhere from 60 to 65, 67 snaps, we ended up having 80. Obviously, you go for it there late in the game on fourth down, and they got a couple run out plays. So, you know, we were close to that number. And we felt like that would have generated us to be able to win the football game. We gave up those two long plays that really, to me, you know, changed the whole complexion of the game.
John Little.
Obviously, y'all knew they had a great offensive team. Did you go into this knowing or with a goal in mind on how many punts to force or turnovers to force, how many times y'all needed to stop to have a chance to win?
You know, John, I mean, I think that, you know, obviously you want to make stops. And with this team, you don't really celebrate third down, because when they cross the 50, third down is second down. So you got to understand you're playing four downs in most situations with this team. They're 4-for-4 on fourth down. We needed to convert some critical you know, third to fourth down situation on our sideline. I believe it was 4th and 9. They hit the spin concept to our sideline. We just missed it. The guy made a good throw. You know, but again, they made some plays in the game today. He was accurate with the ball. They have really good skill people. They created some issues. Dale?
Watching on TV, so it's kind of hard to tell who was in from a personnel standpoint on defense, but it saved you with – was it Jalen Foster who was in there for the most of the time? And why not maybe Jalen Dickerson or some of those other guys playing a little bit more than maybe they
– the opportunity to play, you know. Jalen Dickerson, I believe, had some snaps. Shallow had some snaps. Jamie had some snaps at safety. Israel had some snaps before he injured his groin. So, again, we had multiple guys play back. I don't know exact snap count off the top of my head. Bill?
Yeah, Will. Your defense has given up 159 points
in the last three games. Is the talent difference between the teams you play, their offense, that much greater than what you've got on defense?
Hey, again, I'm sorry.
Did you hear any of the question?
I heard the start. I couldn't hear the finish.
Yeah, the finish was the talent difference between the offenses you play the last three games. Is it that much greater than what you have on defense?
I think we've got to play better. We've got to coach better. You know, it's disappointing that, you know, I think this team that skill-wise is different. But, you know, every game is different, Phil. I mean, it's a 14-point game with Texas A&M. We can't get anything going offensively. It's a team game. We've got to play better team football to complement each other. And we certainly did that in Baton Rouge. We didn't hold up our end defensively. We certainly didn't tonight because offensively we played extremely well. So we've got to play a much better team football as far as those things are concerned.
Yeah, Will, just your thoughts on Colin Hill's play tonight, and how frustrating does it continue to be that you just can't seem to find that second receiver to step up to complement Shy?
Well, again, I think that, you know, a lot of our thought process going into Colin starting the game was, we play better around that position. We all want to point that position when things don't go well and blame him for everything, and that's not really the case. When you go back and look at our first six games, certainly there's some spots he certainly could have played better, made better decisions, sure. But we've got to create more confidence in other positions, and we're striving to do that every single week. Just haven't brought it up. I thought Jalen made some nice catches on the last drive there. Had a couple of nice plays there on the last drive. Nick Muse has been a guy. Jaheim Bell's a young guy that came up, had a big play forced down the middle of the field. So we'll continue to get those guys going. We've got some backs that play well. So Quandre's come on and done some nice things in practice. So get some different personnel groupings and get some more guys at other positions to step up. Yeah.
With Israel, you mentioned the groin. Is that a continuation of that injury that was nagging him earlier? And are you worried about it long term?
Yes and yes. David?
Well, just for halftime, you guys get the fumble, get the ball back. I know that we're probably hoping Harris would bust off a big run. Any thought would be a little more aggressive throwing the ball down the field in the second half?
Well, we felt like, you know, we wanted to try and get the drive started with a run, and then we had an answer for another run that we creased them multiple times in the game, and we took a negative play. So, you know, I know that, you know, that's certainly going to be criticized, but it's the same run that we hit on multiple times in the game, and then we felt like we had a good third down call. They played top heavy on the coverage. We had to throw it underneath and couldn't make the play. So, yeah, I mean, you know, I would have liked to have gotten a drive started and then gone to a hurry up. That was our plan. But we wanted to get the drive started first.
Josh.
Will, what was your message to the team after in the locker room? And do you feel like they're hearing it and that they will bounce back from this after a third tough one in a row?
Not you question anything about their effort and their toughness and how we played in the game. And me and you are going to have a huge disagreement as far as that's concerned. They fought their ass off. We didn't make enough plays defensively. You know, call it like it is. You run for 300 yards and you have 548 yards and 68 plays offensively. You ought to win the football game. We didn't make enough plays on the defensive side of the ball. And, you know, life ain't fair sometimes. So we got to go back at it, and our guys will respond, and they'll respond the right way. Certainly did tonight, and they will again. Colin?
Yeah, well, at times last year you kind of talked about the offense losing confidence and that kind of trickling down to the entire team. Do you feel like the defense has lost confidence at all? And has that trickled to the entire team at all?
I don't think it's trickled to our team based on the offensive performance tonight, but I do feel like that there's some guys that we need to have some better play, against Missouri and some situational ball and build some confidence there. I certainly believe there's some question, you know, kind of where we are defensively right now, and certainly should be. Yep.
You got time for three more. John, Caleb, and Ben. John?
Is T-Rob still calling the defense? And if so, do you look to take over a little bit more on that or make any changes as to how that operation is run?
He's still calling defense, and we need to evaluate where we are.
But what's the process of doing that? Is that something you do in the next 24 hours?
Yeah, we meet tomorrow.
Yeah.
I don't even know if there's something you guys could see on the other sideline, but they made a lot of it on TV with Coach Kiffin throwing his clipboard. I think at one point his clipboard play sheet was thrown into the stands. Is that something y'all noticed or or you and him talked about after the game?
No.
Yeah.
On that play where Moore got loose, uncovered, it looked like
have a middle field safety. He took the pump fake on the X. Corral did a good job of looking him off. Pump fake the X, and it was a double move inside.
Thank you, Will.